Let me get the gate for you.
Faster than your guardian angel can fly.
Like I said, Jack used to say a lot of stupid shit. Deacon out. All right, let's go see what the...
I got this. Hang on. You're gonna die out here. I know of a camp where it's safe.
Camp? I'll go. Where? Show me!
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you so much for stopping. I was so dead. I was never getting out of there. Thank you.
Tell them it was Deacon. They'll know. Don't stop. Just keep out of sight.
So, you want to learn how to hunt? Is that what I'm hearing?
I know how to shoot a gun.
It's a rifle, not a gun.
I was in the 10th Mountain Cope. Don't give me any Marine Corps bullshit.
Killing a buck's a little different than killing a man. Or a freak. The best way to hunt an animal is to track it. You gotta focus. And see what nature's trying to tell you. If you look hard enough, you'll see the signs. Okay, then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh.
Yeah, I see it.
Lead this way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on, man.
Quick, there's your buck.
I see him.
Now here, use my rifle. If you were in the 10th mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this.
Got him. Nice shot.
Oh, goddammit, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
No, no, that's okay. You wounded him. He'll bleed out soon enough. You just gotta track him.
Okay.
See the blood spots? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
Then follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay, you know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look. Cope, Boozer and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say no disrespect to Boozer, but you got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
Hold on. I'll get the game. Hey.
Hey, Manny.
Okay. What now? How am I supposed to fix this piece of crap? Is that supposed to go there?
Okay, man. All right, be seeing you.
I didn't think I'd see you around so much.
We're never gonna finish.
What's
this
up?
Trap.
We got some good shit, if you're buying. Is that all you need? Come by any time. All right.
How's it going, Booze Man?
Fine, goddammit. Hey, Deke, we're getting low on supplies. Use some more meat if you get a chance.
Bullshit. Okay. I guess it's been a while since we did any hunting. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out.
Remember what you're doing?
Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers, believe it or not.
Oh, shit. Don't believe it. Thanks, dude.
See you, Boothman. Alright, now I just gotta find some meat. Deer, bear, wolf.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. I grew up in these here woods. My grandfather taught me all about hunting. Funny how it still works in a world he never would have dreamed of. I built my first treehouse to use as a deer blind. Getting height on your target helps your aim and keeps you safe. Back then, I took out my first doe from up top. Today, my camp's up in the trees. You want to survive and can contribute, you come to me. We got you covered. Grandfather also taught you to catch a doe. Sometimes you gotta lay in ambush. Hide with a watering hole. Today, you're as likely to be prey as hunter. So you gotta keep your eyes peeled when you're hitting the places we all know. But Grandfather always said the easiest way to a good meal was to lay a trap. A snare by a tree, and you could have dinner next time you come round. Careful. A headless snake can still bite, especially when it ain't really dead. Grandfather loved us all. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Oh, that's great, Cope. So you and your granddaddy set traps for him, and you and your old man used to lay down salt licks. Yeah, it's real sporting. I guess none of that shit matters now. Mass grave. I keep forgetting it's so close to O'Leary Mountain. Don't ask me how. Should be it. Let's see. It should work.
Yeah.
Hey, Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check. Speculation as to Tumanus Atratus is confirmed. Lots of numbers from this human have the suit on. The carrion is still mostly intact and appears to be what Aquarius minus or clear. As if anybody could check that. Striation of the larger muscle masses indicate infection of hooligan strain HB. We'll take sample to confirm.
This way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself, and I would have that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, that if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive, O'Brien?
What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night, refugee
Nero
camp.
Protocol 2-7 states
that everyone was dead. They were slaughtered, torn limb from goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little space suit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead. So I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but... I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't... Hey, you don't understand? I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen, I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't going to make it, but I got out of the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
O'Brien,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole O'Brien.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut eye, booze man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, boozer. Real soon. Look. As soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Fire!
Yeah, Deke. Okay.
Get down. O'Brien. Are you out there? O'Brien! Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? I know you're on this channel. God damn it. Okay, you better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it. Oh, come on! O'Brien! Back to me.
Chopper. Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah. Yeah, it was him.
And did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't think she's still alive?
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died.
Some peace.
I don't need to find any peace. Jesus, loser. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
Thank you.
Something under this. Okay, here we go. There we go. I can sell this.
Thank you.
Hey, booze man. I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke, thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.
Should be it.
I know him. Let him in.
How you doing, kid?
They won't let me leave.
Why would you want to leave? It's safe here.
I have to work.
Okay.
With our luck, the infection's gonna spread to the plants.
Can I help you?
How's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
How's life in the shit?
Yeah, yeah.
Got some ears. Good.
That's all I got today.
Sure.
Stop by soon.
This smells like rotten eggs.
That's it.
You here for your bike?
Hey, what's up?
Needs a tune-up. We're gonna run out of this someday, you know. Okay, then. See you later. Hey, man.
Hey, what's going on?
Need anything?
Hey, what's going on?
All right. I see how it is. Later.
Don't make me tell you again.
Hey, back
hey,
to work.
Leave him alone.
Yeah?
Deke, you ever ride with a drifter, scars all over his face, carries a tire iron, goes by the name of Limbo?
Don't know him.
He came into camp yesterday to turn in some bounties, have a few drinks. Seems like he didn't leave until early this morning.
Well, Puck, I don't run security here, so why don't you just tell Alki about that?
He beat a man, Deke, and a woman to death. Bowman and Hewitt. Her face was so smashed in, you couldn't tell it was her.
Hewitt, Maria, right? Jesus. This asshole, Limbo, he's a local.
Alki says they've set up shop at the old Forest Service watchtower on the east slope of Three Finger Jack.
Yep, I know where it is, and, I'll handle it.
I thought you might.